guys, so usually on my posts I am doing videos of me singing and whatnot, but this time I'm gonna try something different. Oh well, not this time, but I am going to do something this time with me talking, and I'm still gonna do my singing videos. However, I also have a degree in journalism and minor in broadcasting, so with that said, I enjoy talking. So with that being said, as I'm repeating myself, I'm going to do a quick recap of the BET Awards of 2016 and what I think of my best performances. And I'm outside talking, so I like to get the nature of the ambience here. So what I think for my best performance for the BET Awards, of course, when I think about it, for going to the Prince tributes, I would say, of course, Jennifer Hudson. Okay, Jennifer Hudson's performance was outstanding. She, as Hollywood has said on television yesterday, she belted out Purple Rain, and that was amazing. And by her being a Chi-Town girl filled with gospel music, coming from church background in church music, gospel music, she knew. So that performance was outstanding. I loved it. It was amazing. I'm a huge fan of Jennifer Hudson anyway, so. And her outfit, she was rocking that feminine version of Prince overcoat hoodie version. I loved it. So my next favorite performer, I have to give it to, of course, the obvious, I should say to her first, Sheila E. Sheila E. was, they saved the best for last. She did phenomenal. I was so proud of her being on stage because, you know, by her being a close friend with Prince, that's hard to do. You know, someone close to you pass away, you have to sing and support, give a new tribute. So she did phenomenal. And I'm also glad to say that I had the privilege of seeing Sheila E. Perform live as I worked at WBON 1690 AM. Shout out to them. Thank you so much for the internship you guys have given me. Wow, that was last summer ago. So it was amazing to see her performance on television, and she did an outstanding job. Of course, before I even stated Sheila E., I still would say Janelle Monae. Oh my gosh, Monae killed it. I love Janelle Monae performance. I'm a huge fan of Janelle Monae, but my cousin's an even more bigger fan than I am. My granddad even loves Janelle Monae. She is the girl version of James Brown. Let me just say my whole family loves Janelle Monae. Her performance was amazing, outstanding. Just, she gave it her all. You know how Prince used to have his butt sticking out? Yeah, she did that. She did that performance. And I loved it. You go ahead, Janelle Monae. You killed it. That's all I can say about it. She killed it. How about that? I said that about 5 times. She did an outstanding job, and would love to see her live in concert. Let's see, my next performance. I was so excited to see was Bilal. If you did not know Bilal before, you knew him after that. Bilal killed it. He gave that Prince sexual vibe to it. I loved it. Outstanding performance. He did a phenomenal job, and I'm so glad that the media gave him recognition, because Bilal been out for a long time. I have a few of my favorite songs that I enjoy by Bilal, as I am a music fanatic. So Bilal performance was outstanding. I loved it, hands down. He killed it. You killed it, Bilal. My next favorite performer, of course, go to Maxwell. I was so glad to see him perform Lake by the Ocean. I love that song right now. That's one of my favorite songs, soul R&B song right now that I am in love with. So I was so glad to see him perform and also give that Prince tribute that he did toward the end. That was a phenomenal transition from his songs to Prince songs. And that, of course, Prince has been dead this past Sunday, 66 days. Today it will be the 68th day of his passing. So And first off, let me say, before I even continue with my performances, my uncle is a Prince fanatic. He is a huge Prince fanatic. Prince fanatic and also a James Brown fanatic. But he is really a huge Prince fanatic. So he was calling my mom. He was calling everybody. Y'all watching Janelle Monae? Y'all watching Sheila E? So he was excited. Okay, so for overall performance besides tributes, Beyonce. Oh my gosh, I was so glad to see Beyonce there live. I was so happy to see her being there. In the flesh. Not that I was actually there, but she was actually live, and I was so happy because Beyonce is a phenomenal entertainer and singer, and so to see her perform her performance Freedom live at the BET Awards along with Coincide featuring Kendrick Lamar, that was a phenomenal performance. And I love the water on the stage. That was great, giving a great creative effect to the performance that she was giving. Something different, and it created some balance with that. So Beyonce killed it. Of course, I was recording while I was watching BET Awards throughout the whole night because I was so excited to see it. And I really enjoyed it. I did. Of course, Anthony Anderson, Tracee Ellis Ross gave their amazing comedic spin on the performances, and I was so happy to see them there in the beginning, giving those that funny introduction with the Hamilton, which is a black play about Anthony Hamilton. But I also want to give recognition to those two young ladies who are under Beyonce's, I believe she founded them as well, Chloe and Haley. That was the most creative and the most artistic musical performance I have seen in a long time on BET Awards, and I loved it. It was amazing. It was just breathtaking to see two young girls perform something phenomenal and creative. And but I was just so happy to see them and to perform. And I was excited. And I've been watching their videos on YouTube before they were even founded by Beyonce. So I'm so glad that they're getting their recognition. So with that being said, overall, and I can't leave out Jesse Williams. Oh my gosh. Jesse was the icing on the cake, on top of a tier wedding cake. He gave it like it is, told the truth, gave something more than just music, but he gave his political stand on what's going on with black people in this world, and he told the authentic truth, whether people like it or not, but it was the truth. And I'm glad that he didn't let it stop him by him being biracial, that he embraces, I'm sure, embraces both sides, but by him being a predominantly a black male, he told the truth, and he was articulate in what he had to say. And I truly respect him for that. He is one of my favorites, besides him being an amazing actor on Grey's Anatomy. He is now one of my favorites because of his amazing activism, giving back to the community. Because in reality, that's pretty much what life is about, giving back to the community, but also fulfilling yourself spiritually. So with that said, guys, overall, I love the BET Awards. It was amazing. I was so happy. I'm so glad to see the movie coming out with Regina Hall and Morris, Regina Hall and, Morris Chestnut. I'm sorry, Morris. Regina Hall and Morris Chestnut. I can't remember the name of the film. Something about, it's a lady that's a surrogate. I cannot remember the name of the film, but I'm excited to see it. So anyway, guys, I hope you enjoyed me talking with the nature being outside. You can't really see much, but you can see the trees about behind me a little bit. Hope you enjoyed me doing this talking. I'm excited. And also, please subscribe to my page. Also, subscribe to me singing as well. I'm thinking about creating another YouTube page. Not sure what I want to call it yet, but it's going to be with me talking, pretty much talking to my talking segments. And yeah, au revoir to you, people. Peace and blessings.